Hi guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. Exotic Roots here, we make natural hair and lifestyle videos. So today I'm gonna go over every hair care tool that you need in your life to achieve your best natural hair journey. So first we're going to start with detangling tools. I prefer using a detangling brush instead of a wide tooth comb because I feel like it removes most of my shed hair compared to a wide tooth comb. When I just started my natural hair journey, all that I knew really was a wide tooth comb, but then when I made the switch to a detangling brush, my life was changed forever. I have two that I like. There's the Felicia Letterwood brush. On Instagram, she's Brush With The Best. And then this one is a Tangle Teaser. There's different styles of Tangle Teasers, so you can definitely get another one, but I like them both. This one I use a little bit more than the Felicia Letterwood brush because I just got this one and I feel like this one is a little bit softer on my hair. The only issue that I have with this one is that it doesn't have any handles. So when I'm in the shower with the conditioner, this gets a little bit slippery and it falls on the floor. I have to pick it up and then start again. I like them both. As I said, I'll probably film a video comparing them both. I tried this one on two of my clients and it went like a breeze. They do have a tighter texture than myself. It is very sturdy, but then your hair doesn't really get caught in it. I love, love, love this brush for tighter textures. And then this one, I like it as well on my hair and also on other textures. Both, you can find them on Amazon. I'll link them down below. Next up, this is a rat tail comb. I use this one mostly for my parts. If you want a precise part, if you want a precise middle part or a precise side part, this one will get you covered. I love using this one because it's very pointy. Don't do too much though because it can really hurt your scalp. There's different materials. There's plastic ones, there's other ones. It's just the one that I have. This is the metal one. And then I like using this comb as well whenever I'm flat ironing my hair. So then I would chase the flat iron with this for a sleeker and smoother look. Next up, we have my pick here. I got it from a regular beauty supply stores, but you can find them as well on Amazon. I like using this to give my hair more volume and to shape my hair. I have fine to medium strands, so first day wash and go, I don't have a lot of volume unless I'm using a very light gel. So then I like using this to just pick my hair up and to give the section a little bit more volume. Next up, we have my brush right there. It's a Bora Bristol brush. You have to be careful with hair brushes. You don't want them to be too hard because it could be very harsh on your edges and on your hair. And then you don't want them to be too soft because it won't have the structure to give you a sleek look and to really lay your hair down. Because when it's too soft, then you're gonna keep brushing and brushing and brushing, and then the repetition is going to be harsh on your hair. So you want that happy medium that you have enough structure, but it's also pretty soft. This one, I got it from Marshall or Runners, I don't remember, but you can also find them on Amazon. I'll show you the difference with a plastic one. The plastic ones are way harsher on the hair and I really stay away from them. I don't know why I still have this one, but this one, I got it from Walmart. It's from the Goody brand, but it's very hard on the hair. I can't even use this because every time that I put it on my hair, I can literally feel it on my scalp scratching. So something like this you need to stay away from, and then get something like this. It is a pretty soft, but you have enough texture to sleek your hair down. Next up, this is an edge brush, an edge control brush. This one, I got it from a beauty supply store. I find them more sanitary and nicer looking than a toothbrush. I love using this if I want to do little designs on my baby hairs. And the little comb here helps you like pull your hair down to make the exact design that you want. I find them pretty handy and they're pretty affordable as well. They're like $2.99 or $3.99, pretty affordable and way better than a toothbrush. Next up, we have diffuser attachments. This one is from my Dyson. This one is from my regular blow dryer that I got from Amazon. And then this one is the Diva Fuser. You can use any model really, depending what works with your blow dryer. I personally prefer drying my hair right after I style it. I don't really like to air dry anymore because I find that I get way better results when I dry my hair right after. A diffuser helps you to distribute the hair flow more evenly and also dry your hair without a lot of frizz. So I love using this when I'm using my regular blow dryer. So this is just an attachment that you put and then you apply on your hair like this to dry it out. I'll probably film a video on how to diffuse your hair, so stay tuned for that. Last but not least, we have hair clips. There's different sizes, different forms. I love using them mostly when I'm washing my hair. I need to part them to either shampoo, deep condition, or also when I'm styling my hair. It helps prevent the other section to get into the other section. These are pretty handy. You can find them at your beauty supply store or off Amazon. That's pretty much it for the video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. If I forgot anything, be sure to let me know in the comment section. And also, follow me on Instagram at Exotic Roots. Subscribe if you have not already. And I'll see you next time for another video. Bye, guys.